So the SneakerBall, this is the 11th year of the SneakerBall, and it's the main fundraising venture for the Greater Washington Sports Alliance and the Greater Washington Sports Alliance Foundation. And the concept was, since the organizations that it supports are ones that use sports to enhance fitness, character, and education in children, we thought, what a cool idea to have sneakers with a black tie, make it a little bit unique. So that's how it originated. This year, the primary beneficiary of the SneakerBall is the Community Fund of Events DC. Well, Events DC is the organization that manages the Convention Center, DC Armory, RFK Stadium, and is responsible for bringing marquee events to the city. And they have a community fund and identify different charities every year that are in need in the district and the surrounding regions that are basically the same, focused on the mission of helping disadvantaged youth with either after-school programs or events that, again, use sports to enhance fitness, you know, in kids. I would say probably about 20% of the women wear sneakers and 99% of the men, so that's okay, you won't get escorted out. It's really a fun event. I mean, I've been to almost 100 black tie events a year in this city, and this is one of my favorite. And it's a high energy event. We have marching drum lines and bands to start it off. We have cheerleaders. It's a very high energy. We have some great honorees this year, with Sheila Johnson receiving the Joseph E. Robert Community Impact Award. We have Katie Ledecky receiving the Athlete of the Year Award. Just a fantastic young Olympian. And London Fletcher receiving the Greater Washington Hall of Champions Award. So it's a fun event. It should be a lot of energy, and we're looking forward to it.
Tonight I will be with Steve and introducing a lot of people. Obviously, London Fletcher's being honored tonight as well. I've come to this event before as a fan and just, you know, like everyone else, so it'll be a good turn to be up there under the bright lights and with a teleprompter again. I haven't been anchoring in a while, so I think I'll dust off the chops and hopefully make a good night of it for everyone. The only thing I'm really competing at lately has been my fantasy football team. So, good thing Steve and I aren't rivals in that. No, we're going to work together, and I think with all these things, it just comes natural, and the jokes come when they do. You can't force it. So, we've both seen each other around at all the sporting events in D.C. many times, so it's good to work together. Team.
Well, it's been 11 years since they've had it, and I've been involved in almost every one of them as an MC. And years ago, Fernando and Bob Sweeney just came to me and said, "Hey, would you help us out as MC?" And and to help us get the ball rolling on this foundation and this charity. And I said, absolutely. And it's been a lot of fun. It's, you know, it's sports oriented. They call it the sneaker ball. You wear your sneakers. I've got mine on. And it's a lot of fun. It's different than a lot of galas, which can be kind of stiff. This one's pretty loose and a lot of athletes, so it's always fun. It winds up being a reunion for a lot of us. We will obviously be guiding the program through. I'm co-emceeing this year with Britt McHenry, who's another sportscaster in Washington. And but we also will have a live auction this year. Now, in years past, we've had a silent auction and a live auction. This year, it's just the live auction, and there are four items, but they're high-end items, beautiful stays at different resorts and trips and jewelry and Super Bowl package. So we'll be doing that live, auctioning those items off as well. And just having fun. Make sure people that are having a good time here, seeing the athletes and recognizing the people that we know as great sports figures and really leaders in the community. And, of course, the whole object is to raise money for charities, children's charities.